So what do we really know about Jesus? Who is this Jesus anyway? Based on our experiences, our encounters, our relationship with Jesus, all of us would have a favorite image of Jesus in our mind. What is your favorite image of Jesus? Well, it's good for us to have a favorite image of Jesus in our mind, but this could lead to danger. Because we would choose to think of Jesus in just those terms and not in others. There's always a danger in focusing on one specific true aspect or true character of Jesus. Throughout the Bible, we see God revealing Himself and His Son to mankind. In the Old Testament, there are more than 300 prophecies concerning Jesus' birth, His life, His death, and His resurrection. And all of these prophecies were fulfilled in the person and in the work of Jesus Christ. I would like to mention two main images and two main names of God given in Scripture, that is used in Scripture, that describes the person and the work of Jesus. Here we have the image of the lion of the tribe of Judah describing Jesus's conquering, describing Jesus as the conquering and the victorious king. The other is that of a lamb, describing Jesus' full, sufficient, and perfect sacrifice that He made on the cross on our behalf, that He made on the cross for mankind. Let's look at a few prophecies or revelations of Jesus in the New Testament. In Luke chapter 1, verses 31 and 32, we read the angel speaking or declaring or appearing to Mary and saying, "And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his king and of his kingdom there will be no end." So based on the prophecies that we just saw, was Jesus truly the lion and the lamb? What do you think? Was he truly the lion and the lamb? Or was he just the lamb and not the lion? Or was he both the lion and the lamb? Well, Jesus was both truly the lion and the lamb. Did he fulfill both of these images? Did he fulfill both of these aspects? Did he fulfill both of these prophecies that were spoken of him? Yes, he did. Come with me to Revelation chapter 5. "Behold, the lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, has prevailed to open the scroll and to loose its seven seals." Now, why was he worthy to open the scroll? So how is Jesus, this lion of the tribe of Judah, that is ascribing to a victorious and conquering king, how does Jesus fit in this role? Because Jesus was the one who conquered sin, death, and Satan on the cross. Jesus came to pay the penalty for our sins once for all. And through his death on the cross, Jesus became the perfect sacrifice, the pure, unblemished Passover lamb who took our place, who made the atonement for our sin, ushering the new covenant of salvation for all who believe and who call on the name of Jesus. What makes Jesus all the more impressive? That his road to being the king started with suffering. The road to becoming the king came through suffering. He did not redeem us by just keeping his status as a lion, but he redeemed us by becoming the Lamb of God. He redeemed us by being that humble lamb.